Who's there? Jim.
Thank you.
missile target identified. Unidentified intruder detected. All it.
Thank you. Got it.
Level Bravo.
is off limits. Hold up there. First time in Good Neighbor? You can't go walking around without insurance.
Insurance?
That's right. Insurance. Personal protection, like. You hand over everything you got in their pockets, or accidents start happening to you. Big, bloody accidents.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Time out. Someone steps at the gate the first time, they're a guest. You lay off that
I like you already. Walk into a new place, make a show of dominance.
Nice. Good neighbors of the people, for the people. You feel me? Everyone's welcome.
Of the people, for the people? Brother.
I can tell I'm gonna like you already. Just consider this town your home away from home. So long as you remember who's in charge.
Mayor Hancock?
Too bad about Finn. Gonna miss him next super mutant attack rolls round. Oh well.
Hey. Well, hello. Everything here is guaranteed to injure, maim, or kill at your discretion. Except me. I only kill when I want to.
Who? What are you?
I'm a woman, baby. Can't you tell?
Oh, of course you are. It's just all those metal plates. You're a robot, right? A very womanly robot?
Designation, Assaultron. Designed to provide a variety of security-related tasks to the modern man. Runtime conclusion. Why work for the man when you can work for yourself? New designation. K-L-E-O. Cleo. Fully independent small business owner. Robot enough for you, smooth talker? Now what are you buying?
You're an Assaultron?
That's what my makers called me. But as far as I'm concerned, I'm a woman. And I run a store that sells very large guns. So what'll it be?
Let's see what you got.
A gun for every occasion.
Check out those
even rolls. A girl with an arsenal.
Sure. I've got a few minutes to browse.
Purchase a variety. Got a weapon here for every situation. Hunting.
Uh-huh. I've got a few minutes to browse.
A gun for every...
Buddy, I gotta be a lot more high or a lot more drunk to be bothered right now.
Every weapon used.
Hate the Institute.
Hey there.
Follow the freedom. New face walks into my store. And you're not even screaming yet. Very polite. You let me know if anything catches your fancy.
Did you say something about people screaming at you?
That's right. Some newcomers have never seen a ghoul before. Can't handle a friendly face, I say. So you need some supplies?
Ghoul? What's a ghoul?
You're looking at one, sweetheart. Didn't have any shelter to go to when the bombs fell. Radiation's kind of the ultimate makeover. Done wonders for my skin. I look pretty good for being 220 years old. Now you buying anything?
Wait. You're 220 years old?
Okay. It's more like 270 years. But don't go blabbing that to everyone. Being a ghoul means you live a long time. You stop counting birthdays. Do you know what it's like being that old?
Actually, I do.
Well, now you're just making fun of me. If you were as old as I was, you would have been around since before the war. So let's hear it. Come on. Tell me what the world was like before the war, if you're so ancient.
I had a beautiful house, white picket fence, and a lawn with the greenest grass you'd ever seen. It was peaceful.
It was, wasn't it? Sorry. Last thing you want to see is an old lady tearing up. Well, you're either the most well-preserved ghoul I've ever seen, or you're the second best bullshitter and good neighbor.
It's the truth. All of it.
You know, if you haven't already, you should check out the Hotel Rexford. There's another pre-war ghoul hanging around there. Well, we should get back to business. What are you picking up?
Sure. Let's take a look.
All the supplies, money, or violence can buy.
Hey.
Stay free, man.
You step through the gate. You got balls.
Excuse me.
What's up? What a day, huh? Everyone's welcome and good neighbor. Even me.
Don't worry. I'll...
Sweet pit boy blues. Hold on.
Hancock says newcomers are welcome to the third rail.
What? Another one of you mercs looking for McCree?
Oi! We got beer. You ain't buying beer, you ain't buying.
Who's the singer?
That is Magnolia. Flower of the third rail. Anything you want to know about her other than that? It's her business. Now, you gonna order?
I'll take a look, sure.
Don't bother tipping. I'm already overcharging you. Now that you're licked up, got a proposition for you. I need a dirty boy to do some dirty, dirty work.
Uh-huh. I want to hear the details first.
I got a certain anonymous client who's paying top dollar for a clean-up job. 3 locations. everyone inside. No witnesses. Only catch? It's all in town. The old warehouses, so I can't use my regulars. Too noticeable. That's where you come in. The job's 200 caps. Payment after it's done. And don't worry. I'll know when it is.
Three locations? That's a lot of time. A lot of bullets.
Well, I guess we could sweeten the pot a bit. 250.
Too low. Barely covers the risks.
All right, Gov. 300.
More money, Charlie.
Giving me a right kick in the elbows. We'll make it 400, but that's as high as I'm going.
I don't do work unless I know who's paying the bills.
All right, Gov. Not like it's a big secret who I represent. Mayor Hancock is fronting the caps. Internal political struggle. You know how it is. Look.
I'll get it done.
You better. Now go out there and bust some heads. We're thirsty for a brand new kind of pleasure. Or are you hungry to be somebody else? Too many.
Excuse me, miss.
What's the matter, handsome? Don't tell me you didn't like the song.
I love the song. It was perfect.
Oh, well, thank you. A girl tries her best. Now, there's something special about you, isn't there? Don't tell me. Let me guess. Ah, of course. It's those powerful muscles of yours. My, I could get used to looking at those. So what brings a man like you to my part of town?
Oh, I woke up here. Just me, my underwear. Regret.
That sounds like the beginning of a great song. I think you and I are gonna get along. So it's my turn to answer questions, right? What can I do for you?
I was wondering if we could get to know each other better.
Oh, really? Go on.
You, me, an evening walk under the streetlights.
And then what?
Music.
I knew you were something special, all right. Let me get my coat.
Yeah. Let's get out of here.
Let me get my coat.
What'll it be?
I haven't been out on the town in too long. Thank you. I'm afraid my first love is always going to be the stage, though. I hope you understand. I just can't get too attached. I'll see you around, good neighbor. When I'm up there singing, I'll be thinking of you.
You! From Sanctuary Hills, right?
Wait, are you from Vault-Tec?
I am Vault-Tec. 20 years of loyal service, and now look at me. I wasn't on the list. But you, look at you. 200 years, and you're still perfect. How? How's that possible?
The vault had these pods that froze us in place. I only thawed out recently.
What? Vault-Tec never told me that. Unbelievable. Well, I had to get to the future the hard way. Living through the filth, the decay, and the bloodshed. Look at me. I'm a ghoul. A freak.
I'm so sorry. I didn't know this would happen.
You know, you're the only other person I met from before. Oh, God. I've been so alone here. No Commonwealth settlement. Once a ghoul with 200 years of Vault-Tec sales experience.
Hey, you know, you could head back to Sanctuary. I'll come visit. I promise.
Really? You will? Okay. I'll head over there right now. You promise you'll come visit, right? I'll see you there.
Before you even start, let's get to the point. We have rooms, one room specifically. Payment due up front.
All right, here.
The room is on the top floor. When you come to the hallway...
Hey, what do you think of the
Hey there. You're new around Good Neighbor, if I'm not mistaken. What do you think of the place?
It's changed a lot since the last time I was here.
Been here before? Well, Good Neighbor's definitely come up in the past few years. Mostly since Hancock took over.
Name's Rufus. I do repairs around here. Keep the robots running, sell a bit of scrap, that sort of thing.
I'm usually here or drinking that swill Charlie slinging at the third rail. Looking for parts? I also might have a job for you if you're interested.
What's the job?
Don't know if you've had the beer down at the third rail, but I swear Charlie must have found it in a sewer.
Found this holotape while doing repairs at the Rexford. Delivery notice for a brewing machine. Pre-war. Thing is, it was never delivered. Well, with all the bombs and all. Done some asking around, and I think it might still be intact. Which is where you come in.
What's the catch?
The usual. Place it's in as an empty. Might have to shoot your way in. Think you can get a hold of that brewing machine for me?
I think I already found it. It's called the Drinking Buddy.
You're kidding. That's the brewing machine I was telling you about. Why don't you let me buy it off you? 100 caps. Plus beer.
No way. I'm keeping it.
Doesn't that just figure? Well, let me know if you change your mind.
I think you've stepped into the wrong place, sweetheart. You don't look like you need the memory den. Do you even know what we do here?
Does it involve a back room and a handful of singles?
Oh, you have the wrong idea, honey. I don't sell skin. I sell memories. And let me tell you, reliving an experience, the right experience, it's far more intense than anything else. But it's not for everyone.
You're cautious. I respect that. But I think I can handle it. If you'll just give me a chance.
Well, I suppose there's no harm in giving you a trial run. Now, memories involving other people are easiest. Recent events involving loved ones. Does anything come to mind?
My wife died recently. If I could see her just one last time.
Oh, honey, I'm so sorry. It's never easy losing someone that close to you. But I think we can help. All right, sit down in the lounger. Let's see what memory we can find.
Dr. Amari? We have a need. Can you find a memory we can plug into?
What kind of memory are we looking for?
Our client is... was married. See if you can find a memory of the spouse.
All right. Scanning the hippocampus. I found something. Very recent. The sync with the temporal lobes is strong.
That's the one. Lift the curtain, honey. It's showtime.
You are. Your memory. Just relax. We'll be monitoring your vitals on this end.
Manual override initiated.
It should have been me.
Biogenic stasis.
Why didn't they take me?
Suspended.
All computers are still working.
How could you be a part of this?
Checking through the logs. Hopefully it's all
just find it. Who are you?
Down the hall near the end.
It should have been me. Why didn't they take me? It should have been me. Why didn't they take me?
This is the one.
Oh my God. Nora! I can't watch this again. No! No, please, no!
Almost. Everything's gonna be fine.
Come here. Come here.
Wait. No, no. I've got him.
Let the boy go. I'm only gonna tell you once.
I'm not giving you Sean!
God damn it.
God.
Get the kid out of here and let's go.
God damn it.
At least
we're
still
kill you.
Backup.
Cryogenic. Reinitialize.
God damn it. I'm gonna kill you.
We are reaching the end of the memory. Hold on. Try to calm down.
It should
Your
have
blood
been
pressure
me.
Is spiking.
Why
I'll have you out of the
me?
3, 2, 1.
It should have been me. Why didn't they take me?
Easy there, sweetheart. Easy. I'm so, so sorry. If I had any idea that we were going to put you through that again, I would have said no.
Wasn't there any other memory you could have found?
I told you. We find the clearest memory we can for the first time. That one stood out. You need help, sweetheart. And I know just the man. His name's Nick Valentine. He's a detective. Works out of Diamond City these days. If anyone can help you find your missing child, it'll be him.
Memories of Vault 111?
I'm so sorry we put you through that again.
Amari.
The memory loungers are complex pieces of equipment. Please don't lean on, jump on, or kick them.
Nick Valentine's helped a lot of people, sweetheart. Hook him up.
You got the memory pod loaded up?
Oh, you're not Irma.
Hey.
Good neighbor's crazy. Thefts, murders, worse. Sometimes you just gotta escape a little to make it through the day.
Escape? What do you mean?
Reliving old memories. Like Thanksgiving, 2071. Mom made a 12-pound turkey. And then we all listened to the Silver Shroud versus Captain Cosmos. Even Pa was there. You ever listen to the Silver Shroud? That's what we need. No matter how bleak things got, he saved the day.
My family and I used to listen to every new episode.
You mean when they first aired? How? The last broadcast was hundreds of years ago.
I was in cryogenic storage for a long time. I only just woke up.
Oh man, that's amazing! You're just like Mr. Abominable from episode 83.
Who's Mr. Abominable?
He was a caveman. Got frozen in an iceberg from prehistoric times. When they thawed him out, he went on a rampage. It took the Shroud and Man-to-Man combined to take him down. Boy, if you just woke up. The world these days must take some getting used to.
That's an understatement.
Things may look bad, but we gotta try to make it better. I got a question for you. What if the Silver Shroud was real? With his black trench coat and gleaming silver submachine gun? I got a plan to bring him to life. So he can fight bad guys and give the rest of us a symbol of something better.
What plan?
I've built my own custom machine gun. Even better than the one in the show. But to make this work, I still need the most important piece. The genuine Silver Shroud costume herself. And they actually got one here in Boston. They made it for the TV show. Will you help?
I might do it, if you make it worth my while.
I can give you some caps up front. Just promise you'll help me.
As it happens, I already have your costume.
There she is, pretty as the posters. The Silver Shroud costume herself. And memorabilia, too? You're something else. Together with my gun, everything's all set.
Here you go.
After all these years, the Silver Shroud is born again. But there's just one problem. I'm just not Silver Shroud material. I could be Rhett Reinhardt, or his butler, Jarvie Blake. But the Shroud is strong, capable.
What happens to this suit?
Oh, I have an idea who should wear it. You up for being the Silver Shroud? You already got your own origin story and everything. What with the Cryo Vault and all.
If I go along with this, I could use a little extra.
If it'll get you to help, sure. I may be able to scrounge up a couple of things.
Looks like I get to be the Shroud.
The costume and gun are yours. So you patrol good neighbors' streets, and I'll call in any crimes on my radio station. Here... some calling cards, I guess. When you dispatch justice, leave them behind. That way, everyone knows the Silver Shroud has returned. Time to fight crime!
Thank you.
calling all Silver Shroud fans. A once-in-a-lifetime announcement. The Silver Shroud returns, and he's gonna clean up the streets. Everyone heard how Wayne Delancey murdered Miss Selmy and her kid over a few lousy caps.
Can't believe it.
Death is coming for you, Wayne.
Galaxy News!
Step away from my meat, boy. Unless you want to be
next. When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows.
Rumor is he killed Miss Selmy. That true?
Selmy? Yeah, I killed the bitch. And her whelp, too. Shouldn't have bothered, they barely had two caps between them.
You listen to the radio? Someone wants you dead.
You threatening me?
Well,
are you threatening me?
Well. Looks like
that's your last mistake, asshole. You mess with me, you're dead.
Yeah. Wrong side of the tracks.
I'm just meeting a friend.
No, what just happened?
Yours, perhaps I'll just call him. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Not so fast, fancy pants. Your wallet. And that snazzy briefcase you're carrying. Hand them over. Now.
Friend of the show, Jerry, is here.
Is this thing on? Hello? Hello?
It's on. We're recording in here. Aw, man. Great. Great. The Silver Shroud's dispatched justice already. Miss Selmy has been avenged.
Shit, the Shroud off Wayne? Wait, so this guy's actually for real?
Oh, you better believe it. So Jerry, go on. Tell the listeners about what we're talking about.
Right. So AJ, you know the chem dealer by Bobby's. He's doing good for himself. Says he's got a whole new market. Kids. Even with his garbage chems, he's just rigging it in the caps.
You hear that? Sounds like the Silver Shroud has another bad guy to deal with.
Why? This Shroud guy, he's gonna muscle in on the cap trade?
No. He's gonna do something about it. AJ's selling the kids. His chems have killed people.
And? I don't get it.
We can't let AJ kill kids.
Keep your hands where I can see.
Whatever.
Hey, you. This is my turf. And I don't appreciate what you call them, you know, trespassers.
Beat it.
When evil walks the...
Do ya? Oh, Christ. You can't put you up to this? He keeps moaning about the poor little kids. What the hell, right? Tell you what. I'll pay you... let's say 50 caps just to shut up about it. And maybe get Kent off my back, all right?
Silver Shroud.
For 50 caps? No way.
All right, fine. Make it 75.
A lousy 25 caps more? Are you trying to insult me?
Hey, 75 is a gift.
All
right, fine. I give you 90 if you just leave me in goddamn peace.
You don't understand. How much are you willing to pay to keep breathing, pal?
Whoa. Hey, easy there. I got friends, powerful friends. But we can deal. Call it 200 caps and just walk away. We all come out ahead. Nobody goes to the bone house.
Indeed they are, my intrepid investigator.
Hand over the caps.
Here. And don't show your face around here again.
Just keep your hands.
He was here to meet with some others.
The Silver Shroud is bringing justice to Good Neighbor. You bad guys better look out. Now, special update. The villainous assassin Kendra was recently spotted at the third rail. The same Kendra who bombed Little Joe's shack and killed four innocent drifters. If you want to see the Silver Shroud in action, stay near Whitechapel Charlie. The Shroud's sure to interrogate him to find the evildoer's whereabouts.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode in the Parlor of Mysteries.
Jasmine. Chamomile. Pain. Ecstasy. This can only be the dead. Of mysteries.
Shh. Be still, sweet Shroud. I removed that scumbag slug, but you're sick with fever and still suffering.
Mistress of mysteries, no. I'm all right. Hey. But the mayor.
What?
Fat Fady.
Charlie.
We still make way for sinister blood, old friend.
What a pipe, mate. You're here for Magnolia,
no,
better drink up.
The Shroud stumbled.
No tolerance for freedom.
The mistress maneuvered. I knew of the mayor's misdeeds for many days.
Kendra.
Kendra is not one to be trifled with. People associated with her have a habit of being found face down in a ditch. You're set on meeting her.
Can you spare a few details on her, at least? On the house?
You got to have finesse to be an assassin. Kendra's a murderer. A very skilled murderer. Listen, mate, the combat scan shows you know what you're about. Save your caps, buy a lager instead.
Is an unfortunate and unexpected.
I'm not hiring her. I'm going to kill her.
Are you serious? Sarcasm sometimes bungs up me processes. In that case, she's got a flat just south of Good Neighbor. Water Street Apartments. Look out for the blighters she's got with her. Nasty piece of business, then. Good luck.
We can clear this up. Come out now, Hunter! I'll see that you two get the best lawyers in the city!
Excuse my assumption that even the most astute attorney couldn't help us now.
All right, enjoy your stress. We must away from your den and evade the police. Clear our names and take Fahey down.
Another special update. No, it wasn't Bobby No-Nose who offed AJ and his goons. It was the Silver Shroud. See his calling card if you don't believe me. Now's our time, listeners. Justice is coming to Good Neighbor.
Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, Fat Fahey's Volume.
Come on, Dollface. It's right through here.
Aw, oh, gee, Polly. I ain't never been in a secret gangsta hideout before.
What the? Paul, you dumb jamoke! What's the big idea? Bringing a dame into our hideout! Into my hideout! Now relax, boss. She's alright. Ain't you alright, Wendy? Cindy? Yeah.
It's Candy. And yeah, of course I'm alright. I'm just a young, dumb girl in love with a handsome, dangerous man.
Want a room? Claire runs the desk. Give her something to do besides breathing down my neck.
Hey there. You're new around Good Neighbor, if I'm not mistaken. What do you think of the place?
Why do you ask?
Just trying to... Name's Rue. I'm usually here. Uh-huh. Looking for parts.
What's the job?
Don't... Thing is, it was... Which is weird.
I think I already found...
You're kidding, Hunter Cat.
A robot like this?
Of course. So do we have a deal?
Do you know how many raiders I had to clear out to get...
Fair point. Three...
Hey, Rufus.
How's it going? Are you looking for scrap? Or did you change your mind about selling me the drinking buddy?
Not right now.
Sure. See you around.
Fred, are you going to hang out in the lobby all day again? Or are you actually going to go down and do some work?
Being available to the customers is work. It's not all about cooking chems, Claire.
Not all about sampling those chems either. Maybe if you stop using, you can focus.
What? Where's the fun in cooking it if you ain't using it?
My mistake. I think you've stepped into the wrong place, sweetheart. You don't look like you need the memory den. Do you even know what we do here?
Does it involve a back room and a handful of singles?
Oh, you have the wrong idea, honey. And let me tell you,
You're cautious. I respect that. But I think I can handle it.
Well, I suppose there's no... Now, memories involving other people are easiest. Recent events involving loved ones. Does anything come to mind?
Can it be about something else?
Well, this is a trial run. I want to see how you handle a clear memory. And in all my time doing this, nothing stands out like love and family.
My wife died recently.
Oh.
Right.
All right. Dr. Amari, we have a... Can you find a memory we can plug into?
What kind of memory are we looking for?
Our client is... was married. See if you can find a memory of the spouse.
All right. Scanning the hippocampus. I found something. Very recent. The sync with the temporal lobes is strong.
That's the one. Lift the curtain, honey. It's showtime.
Here you are, your memory. Just relax. We'll be monitoring your vitals on this end.
Manual override initiated. Cryogenic stasis suspended.
Both computers are still working. That's good. Checking through the logs. Hopefully it's all...
Just find it.
Pod C6, down the hall near the end.
This is the one. Here.
Open it.
Is it over? Are we okay?
Almost. Everything's going to be fine.
Come here. Come here.
Wait. No, no. I've got him.
Let the boy go. I'm only gonna tell you once.
I'm not giving you, Sean!
God damn it.
God.
Get the kid out of here. Let's go. At least we still have a backup.
Cryogenic sequence reinitialized.
We are reaching the end of the memory. Hold on. Try to calm down. Your blood pressure is spiking. I'll have you out of there in 3, 2, 1.
Easy there, sweetheart. Easy. I'm so, so sorry. If I had any idea that we were going to put you through that again, I would have said no.
You sat back and put me through that again? You owe me.
You're right. Here, a small consideration for everything you've been through. But honey, what you need is a detective. I have a friend, Nick Valentine. He works out of Diamond City. If anyone could help you find your missing child, it'll be him.
You got the memory pod loaded up? Oh, you're not Irma. Good neighbor's crazy. Daph's murder's worse.
I hear you.
It's rough in the best. You ever
live? My family and I used to live.
You mean?
I was in cryogenic storage for.
Oh, man!
Wasn't he?
Yeah, that's the one. Boy.
It seems like people are finally rebuilding. And...
maybe in some parts. Like, that. What if the Silver Shroud was real? I got a plan to bring.
What plan?
I've built my own.
Sure.
But to make this work, and they actually got one here.
I might do it if you make.
I can give you some caps up front.
I might do it.
I can give you some.
As it happens.
There she is. And memorabilia, too.
Here you go.
After all, I'm just not Silver.
Right.
What happens to the suit?
Oh, I have an idea. You up for being the Silver?
If I go along with this...
if it'll get you to help, sure.
Looks like I get to be the Shroud.
The costume and gun are yours. So here's... some calling cards, I guess. When you dispatch Justice, leave them behind. That way, everyone knows the Silver Shroud has returned. Time to fight crime!
Like Sammy, too.
Sure as hell didn't act like it. Institute thinks they can replace people with synths in this town? They've got another thing coming.
What am I gonna tell his mom?
I hate to... Thank you.
Light him up!
What the?
Lost him.
Thank you.
fixing up. Let's get a look at you.
Yeah. Take a look at me, Doc.
Now go over your symptoms for me. One at a time.
Took a few bad hits recently. Got knocked around.
Scrapes and bruises. But it's probably a good idea to get them fixed up. Done. Now, was there anything else bothering you?
No, we're done.
Off you go, then. Got a dangerous look about that. Hope you ain't here for me.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.